Allah wanted to give the ultimate test. And do you know what was this ultimate test? The ultimate test for a person is his child. This was the ultimate test. Because just imagine, you know, we take things in life very granted. Alhamdulillah, everything is nice, we get married, we have wife, then suddenly children, oh mashallah, subhanallah, and the aqeeqah is done. But how much have we cried for this child? How many years have we cried for this child that we have today in front of us so easily? Just imagine, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam for 86 years, continuously he's saying to Allah, Rabbi habli min as-salihin, Rabbi habli min as-salihin, Rabbi habli min as-salihin, for 86 years. I mean, after 10 years, you'll be hopeless. There's many people, after 15 years, they get hopeless and they say, no, this lady is wrong, I need to get married to another lady. Isn't it? Simple as that. But Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, keeping his firm conviction and reliance and the hope on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah give us true conviction, true reliance, true tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very hard. True tawakkul, true reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah give us steadfastness and strength to strength on Iman Islam. And make these lives of the prophets not just a story or not just a fairy tale. Make these lives implement in our lives. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, all his life is making dua that, oh Allah, give me a righteous child. Rabbi habli min as-salihin. The ulamas have said that if you have a child, if you already have a child, alhamdulillah. If you don't have a child, then start making dua from now that Allah give you a pious child. And if you have a child who is not pious, who is not righteous, start making dua now that Allah rectify him. Because Allah says in the Quran, Rabbi awzi'ni an ashkura ni'mataka allati an'amta 'alayya wa 'ala walidayya wa an a'mala salihan tardah. Allahumma aslih li fi dhurriyyati wa aslih li fi dhurriyyati. Oh Allah, rectify my child, rectify my child. Is never the end for your child to be rectified, not to be rectified. Is never the end for your child not to be rectified. So the first and formal thing is very important that we make dua that Allah give us a righteous child. So he made dua that, oh Allah, give me a righteous child. Allah gave him a righteous child, but this righteous child, Allah says, فَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِغُلَامٍ حَلِيمٍ. Regarding Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah said that this child, he will be a forbearing, a tolerant child. And regarding Ishaq alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah says, فَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِغُلَامٍ عَلِيمٍ. We will give you a glad tidings of a child who will be a knowledgeable, a well-known child, who will be well-acquainted in knowledge. Which means, today, from time to time, the people of the books and the people of the scriptures, the Ahlul Kitab, they have differed in this matter. They say that the Zabih of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was Ishaq alayhi salatu wasalam. That's why mentioning these two ayats, the main thing is that we not going to anything else and not going into the ikhtilaf of the a'immas and not going into the tafasir of the Quran, just understanding these two ayats, what is Allah saying? That Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam is a forbearing and tolerant child. And Ishaq alayhi salatu wasalam will be a knowledgeable child. Which means that Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam from his birth, and he would do such a deed, such an act, and such a forbearing, and such a tolerant, such a sabr, such a patient act, that it will not be equal in the history on the earth until the day of Qiyamah. And this Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam and his father has shown. And what was this? That they were ready, Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam was ready to give his life for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was ready to give his life for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said that, oh my son, I see you, inni ara fil manam anni adbahuka fanzur ma tara. That, oh my child, I see in the dream that I have been sacrificing you. He didn't say sacrificed you. I have been sacrificing you. Which means, I have been seen, I am doing the acts of sacrifice. If, the scholars they say, if Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam wanted to, he could have done ta'wil. He could have done ta'wil. He could have said maybe this could be true or not. True or false. But Allah for constant 3 days. And obviously we understand and we know that the dream of the Anbiya is matlu', is wahi. It is matlu', it is wahi. Matlu', ghayr matlu'. The ulamas have talked about this. So the dreams of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam is wahi, revelation. It is revelation from Allah. So for 3 constant days he sees, the Mufassirun have written, that he sees that he is sacrificing. And the first day was the 8th of Dhul Hajjah, which is Yawm Tarweeh, the day of doubts. The next day, when he saw again, it was Arafah. According to some narration of the ulamas, they say that this was the day when he recognized. And then he took the initiative to get the preparation ready on the 10th of Dhul Hajjah in Mina to sacrifice his son. And obviously the story is long, that he goes to Mina, then Shaitan comes, he pelts him 7 times, then he goes again, Shaitan comes and he pelts again 7 times, then he goes again and he pelts 7 times, like the Hujjaj are doing today. So this motto of Hajj, it is all related, especially to Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam. But Allah wanted to, in ultimate way, do and leave a such a sign until the day of Qiyamah, that all the Ummah to be coming until the day of Qiyamah, who will be getting the reward? Ibrahim alayhi salam. And that's why Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam's life and looks wise, it resembles a lot of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, in resemble wise, I look like Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. In look wise, Hazrat Aisha, sometimes radiallahu ta'ala anha, sometimes she used to take the oath of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, and sometimes she used to take the oath of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, but I used to realize and understand when you're not happy with me that you take the name of Ibrahim. And when you are happy, then I used to realize and understand that you used to take my name. So anyway, this is something additional I just wanted to say. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he in resemble wise looked like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what is the most defining thing and the most important thing about Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam? It was the sacrifice of his son. But because of this sacrifice, because the act and the initiative that he took, Allah has accepted this so much. وَفَضَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah says, we have gave you a great sacrifice. بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah says, إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْبَلَاءُ الْمُبِينُ. This is a great manifest test. And وَفَضَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. And we have gave you a fidya. Fadayna is from fidya. And what is fidya? As we understand, according to Islamic verdict, we understand that if a person cannot fast, what does he do? He gives fidya. So because Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam has took the act and initiative to do this qurbani in the place of this fidya, Allah has gave this ram. And this ram came from Jannah. And obviously there's so many things you can talk about the ram. Some scholars, they say that this ram was the ram of Habib, the son of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. But these narrations are not very strong. But anyway, so this ram came from Jannah, direct from Jannah. That's why Allah says, بِذِبِحٍ عَظِيمٍ. It's not just a normal ram. It is a great ram and a great sacrifice, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam to give. And not just this, Allah says, وَتَرَقْنَا عَلَيْهِ آخِرِينَ. That we will leave this as a sign until the day of Qiyamah. So Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, this qurbani, this day of Eid, Eid al-Adha, which is the qurbani Eid, the sacrifice is Eid. Hazrat Zayd ibn Arqam, he said, Ya Rasulullah, ma hadhihi al-adahi? What is this sacrifice? Sunnah abikum, it is the sunnah of your father. A person who thinks, and I've mentioned this last week on Jum'ah, a person who thinks that a person giving sacrifice once a year, it is something that is not very important. And if a person thinks, I am wasting my money on sacrifice every year, then this person has not understand the essence and the importance of sacrifice. Allah Ta'ala says, the blessed food is that food, the blessed meat is the day when the Hujjaj and the people, his servant, are sacrificing on the day of Eid. Allah has put immense blessings in this meat. So it's very, very important. It comes in the narration in the hadith, that if a person has the capability, if a person has the possessed the ability and means to do sacrifice, and if he's the sahib al-isab, if qurbani is wajib upon him, and he doesn't do his qurbani, then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, فَلَا يَأْتِي مُصَلَّانَا. May he not come to my musalla. May he not come to my musalla. What does this mean? May he not come to the Eidgah, to the place and the platform of Eid, and to do Eid. It's so emphasized and so much importance that has been given to Eid. Salat al-Eid. Salat Eid, the Qurban, the sacrifice of Eid. So inshallah, hopefully, I think everyone who's sitting here, I hope inshallah every one of us have gave our qurban inshallah. Have we gave our qurban?
Inshallah.
Inshallah. May Allah accept our qurban and make this a means, and make our qurban in the day of qiyamah a means and zariya of our salvation from the emancipation, from the fire of Jahannam, for the eternal peace of Jannah. For the eternal peace of Jannah. Wallahi, brothers, I'm saying in the house of Allah, that everything that we are doing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world, we will only realize when we will close our eyes tomorrow. When we will close our eyes tomorrow, we will understand the importance of Qurban. We will understand the importance of Hajj. We will understand the importance of one salah. We will understand the importance of giving our zakah. We will understand the importance of fasting in the month of Ramadan. Until then, we will not realize. So may Allah accept our qurbani, accept our hujjaj ikram. And I have said that those people who sit in here, who have not gone to Hajj, or who have not been to Hajj, he should start making the firm intention now. He should make the intention from now that next year I'm going to make the preparation to go to Hajj. I'm going to make the intention to go to Hajj. Get this done as soon as possible before time is less. There's time. There's no more time for us. There's no guarantee in our life, brothers. There's no guarantee. There's no guarantee. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our qurbani, accept our deeds, and accept us coming to this day of Eid. جزاك الله خيرا سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك.